Several media organizations, including the parent company of Western News, say they intend to sue for access to George Zimmerman's statements about why he shot and killed Trayvon Martin. West 2's Bob Keeling reports both prosecutors and the defense will ask to keep that crucial information secret until Zimmerman's trial.
This video shows George Zimmerman the day he gave his third statement to investigators about his fatal shooting of Trayvon Martin. But are his statements a confession to a crime or an explanation of why he acted in self-defense? Defense attorney Richard Hornsby says Zimmerman's statements can make or break the case for either side.
The crux of both the state and the defense's case is the defense is going to make their case off of these statements, and the state hopes to break his case off of these statements and the inconsistencies they may show.
Prosecutors argue that Zimmerman's statements can be seen as a confession and by law cannot be released to the public along with other evidence. West 2's parent company, the Hearst Corporation, and other media organizations are opposing that stance. They argue Zimmerman's claims of self-defense are not the same thing as a confession and are not exempt from public records laws. Hornsby disagrees.
This is purely a black letter law issue. Is this considered a confession or admission or is it not? If it's considered a confession or admission, the judge is going to say it's not required to be disclosed.
Judge Ken Lester has given this order to unseal the court file once before. But if the issue over Zimmerman's statements is whether it could affect his right to a fair trial down the road, legal experts say they don't expect him to side with the media and make Zimmerman's statements public. Reporting in Orange County, I'm Bob Keeling, West 2 News.